Hi there and welcome back to Japan. Today I'm going to be doing a bit of a special review because we're going to be reacting to Perfume, and the song is called Flash. I believe this is the newest one. Now, you might be aware that Perfume are representing Japan, which is a lot of Japanese artists don't break out, especially to America, that big, although there has been some recently with Baby Metal and etc., who we've covered on this channel. But Perfume have been around for quite a long time. They're well established in the Japanese pop scene, and they're breaking out to America in a big way and doing one of the big festivals. I can't remember which one it is, but I'll certainly tag it up on this video when I check after I've done. Anyway, I want to check this out because one of the things is that Perfume are an artist who they're so big in the pop music industry that you hear them around but haven't really ever paid a huge amount of attention. And I've got a couple of friends who are big fans, and one of the things that is always mentioned is they have a fantastic stage show. I mean, really impressive. Some of the people they employ to do their stage stuff are, you know, your top level people. I think one of them's even doing the Olympics in 2020 here in Tokyo. But I am in Tokyo right now. But this one is something I've never really watched one of their videos. So I'm assuming that that's what grandeur will come across. I also know that they share a producer with Carrie Pammy Pammy, who's an artist who I've seen her live on a couple of occasions. I've done reviews of her work for a magazine. So there's a lot of reasons why I should enjoy this and a lot of questions as to why I haven't checked them out more. So maybe my expectations are set a bit high, but we're going to dive in and see what we think. So like I say, this is Flash, which is, from what I can tell, the latest Perfume video. Join me. 3, 2, 1, go. See how they've grown beyond the normal sort of teenage 20s Japanese group, and the sound is, the production, you can tell it's like Kiari's. Although I suspect they were first, you know what I mean. Here we go. Something big to happen when they all came together. Spelling something? Probably not. That's quite a hook, actually. I nearly dropped my computer. Don't know if we just had an earthquake or something, but... Nice touch. See, this is the sort of visual stuff I was talking about. This coming back in, that's what, that kind of lighting stuff is what I'm expecting to see from them. Into that and walk out of that knowing that I have a lot of false equivalencies that I have to work out, and so I'm going to judge it from the perspective that I can, which is that one. Realistically speaking, I think that one of the things that is most noticeable is that the sound, the production, yes, straight away from the very first notes, it's the same sort of synths, the same sound that's being used for them as for Chiari. And like I say, I kind of appreciate that they are, you know, Chiari, if you like, is riding off their coattails rather than the other way around. But, you know, you can hear that immediate similarity in sound. And so, but not in a negative way. I mean, it's a very creative sound that producer has. I can't remember his name. But all of the benefits of that, fantastic catchy chorus, fantastic beat, just everything about that kind of worked. And so the song itself was brilliant, very catchy. I'm going to be honest and say, I mean, a lot of reviewers, and especially considering a lot of the content on this channel, it might be seen as that I'm just like a rock guy. Nothing could be further from the truth. I love pop. And that is definitely a song that I'll be listening to again. The video, like I say, again, false equivalencies based on the fact that I know how visually oriented they are a lot of the time. And because of the fact that obviously I'm relating a lot of this to Chiari, who is incredibly visual in what she does. That's like a whole thing. I was expecting more, but I'm not going to say I was disappointed. In actuality, in a way, it was kind of pleasing that it was so simple. You know, the simple lines, the shading, the shadows, the lighting, the simple performance. The lack of any real gimmick made it quite refreshing, easy to watch. Yeah, I enjoyed the video. When the whole the light thing came in, I hate to say this, but I'm going to have to do the equivalency to Star Wars now. The whole Star Wars lightsaber thing came in. That was fantastic, really cool, really nice. It was weird that it was so different from, you know, 80% of the rest of the video, but it was just kind of in there. But, you know, it was such a simple video that they could do those things and they worked. Just to annoy some people, to annoy some nerds, geeks, and Americans, and, you know, most of the population of the planet, I don't actually like Star Wars. I wish there was a live way I could see all the thumbs downs being pressed on this video right now. Anyway, but yeah, the point is, so when I'm looking at it, I'm not thinking cool Star Wars. I'm thinking cool, really cool lighting effects, visual. That was just a really fantastic video. Could they have done more? Maybe. You know, when you look at the range of variety, again, sorry for doing this comparison, but the range of variety and visual things that Chiari's had in her videos, maybe that could have had more. And considering that they had such a fantastic idea that occupied such a small percentage of the overall video, I wonder if they could maybe have got a couple more ideas equally pleasing rather than just the two setups and have more things happening in it. But you know, these are nitpicks. Great video. The song was much better than I expected. Not that I had any reason to expect low, but I'm really pleased that was good. So yeah, one of the things I mentioned this earlier, but I think there's always this thing, and I don't want to sort of jump into Japanese stereotypes or anything, but I know there is this thing where a lot of people think, you know, Japan always obsessed with the sort of young girl image, and, you know, looking at bands like Baby Metal, who we've covered, who are very young and things like that. Sometimes it comes across that, you know, it's only the young women who have a chance. So it's nice to see a group of women who are clearly, as far as I can see at least, you know, Japanese women usually look much younger than they really are. They look like they're, I'm guessing, probably in their 30s now, because they've been around for a while. And they just look like they're good, they're having a good time, they're doing the dances perfectly. Just everything about that was really refreshing. What can I say? I'm really happy that they're going to be performing in America. I hope it goes well, and I hope we see a lot more of them, because that's it's a good bit of pop. So, thank you very much. Like I say, get in the comments, like, unlike, whatever you want to do. And I will see you next time you choose to join me in Japan, which will probably happen easier if you subscribe. Yes, YouTube style. We're begging for subscribes. Take care. See you soon.